Hi, I'm Dr. Diane Cleverley, personal healthcare information. Welcome to this episode of Frequently Asked Questions. Today, we're going to be talking about measles. What is up with measles? It's all over the news lately. And unfortunately, instead of providing scientific information, the only information that's out there right now is the vaccine debate. As you probably know, measles virus outbreak has been confirmed in 15 states so far. So you probably want to learn how to protect your family. To do that, you probably want to know, what is the measles? Measles is a viral infection, so antibiotics are not effective for treatment. After you get exposed to the measles virus, and that means coming in contact with somebody who has measles, it takes 10 to 12 days before you actually get sick. When a person first develops a measles virus infection, they get a cold-like syndrome for 2 days before the rash actually appears. And the rash is not the problem, it's the complications. Did you know that 3 out of 10 people who get infected with measles virus actually do develop complications? The rate of serious and life-threatening complications from the measles virus is about 0.2%. That's 2 in 1,000. If you want to compare that to the vaccine, which has a risk of serious complications from the vaccination, it's less than 1 in 1 million doses. Pneumonia is one of the worst complications, and that's the one that's responsible for most of the deaths of the 1.5 million deaths that occur worldwide each year. Why is measles so hard to contain? Well, the reason is that the person who is infected with measles virus can appear perfectly healthy when they're shedding measles virus. The other thing about measles virus is that it's spread through coughing. Aerosolized drops of measles virus appears after a person coughs, and it can linger in the air up to 2 hours. It can also fall on surfaces and be transmitted that way. Another scary thing about measles is 90% of susceptible people will actually get sick if they are exposed. That's a really high infectivity rate for a virus. So, you're probably wondering how you can protect yourself. Of course, the best way is to get vaccinated. Remember, not everyone who is vaccinated is fully protected. Sometimes, you can have a window between the first dose and the second dose, which for children can be up to 4 years, in which a certain percentage of people are not protected. You can also have vaccine failure in adults who were vaccinated as kids, but then for some reason those memory cells, which are supposed to remember the virus and go into high gear as soon as they see it again, they just didn't form properly, they're not working, or they've died off. Another thing that can happen is adults and children can both become susceptible if their immune system fails. So it's really hard to mount immune response to a measles virus if you have leukemia, lymphoma, or other immunocompromising diseases.
The truth is you can always go to your pediatrician or your physician and ask for a catch-up vaccination. So people can be vaccinated at any age.
One thing you can do is to avoid crowded spaces where people might be coughing or spreading those aerosolized droplets. Another thing you can do is to avoid places with infants or children, like daycares and hospitals. Some other measures that may help prevent viral infections are to wear respiratory masks and to decontaminate surfaces. You can also try hand sanitizer, but it has to be 70% alcohol or it will not disrupt the viral membrane. Remember, most of these measures, they're not directly related to measles. The best information I can find for preventing measles was to get vaccinated. So I had to take these other measures from what is known to protect you from orthomyxoviruses and other paramyxoviruses. Remember, even with control measures, measles can still be spread. Thank you for listening. I look forward to seeing you on the next episode of Frequently Asked Questions. Be sure to subscribe so you can get updates.
Thank you for listening. And for more information, please visit us on the web at personalhealthinfo.weebly.com.